I hope that this camp was sort of a spark moment for them, that they had a natural ability they didn't know about, and something like this camp set that spark off, and who knows what path that may take them.
Organizers of the Smart Girls Camp at Pennsylvania College of Technology hope that path leads to STEM careers. With the help of the Carnegie Science Center's Mobile Fab Lab, the college showcased career possibilities in science, technology, engineering, and math for 40 high school girls from throughout the state.
We recognize that girls tend to shy away from math and sciences and even technologies and engineering. So we find that it's very important that they realize that they are very competent and capable.
That message is critical when it comes to STEM. Women make up nearly half the U.S. workforce, but according to the National Science Board, they account for only 29% of science and engineering workers.
The ramifications are that they end up in job positions that are maybe not at the level that they could be working at. They're not having the impact on society that they could be having.
The way that I got the next one to go.
A male or a female are doing the exact same problem. That cultural thing of like females aren't doing engineering, they aren't doing mathematics, it's to me it's just ridiculous.
The Smart Girls proved that by meeting the quadcopter challenge, regarded as the Mobile Fab Lab's most difficult project.
So there it is, go back and give it a shot, see what you think.
The girls removed the guts of a new quadcopter before spending the next couple days designing and building their own to fly through an obstacle course.
I really liked designing the frame of the copter, and then the laser cutter was really cool to see it work. I've never done something like this. I didn't make a big fuss over my mistakes because sometimes I tend to do that. I just like brushed it off and I kept trying until I actually got it right.
It's a lot of walking back and forth between the flying room and the like fixing your drone room. I had to walk back and forth at least 5 to 7 times to finally fix my drone.
They did not give up. So I hope they could take that and not only apply it to STEM classes they may take in high school or college or beyond, but they can apply that to other areas of their life.
The girls also learned life lessons from female executives via Skype sessions and explored college and career pathways through reading assignments.
The book was really valuable. It was basically explaining how to get to college and really pursue what you want to do and figure out what you want to do with your life so you have a plan.
It helped guide us where we wanted to go in our career, where we want to work, what we want our community to be like.
If the girls decide to be part of the STEM community, the opportunities should be plentiful and lucrative. STEM occupations are growing faster than other sectors of the economy, and the U.S. Department of Commerce calculates that STEM professionals make 29% more than their non-STEM counterparts. Camp organizers believe the girls embraced that reality.
The group that we have this week is really phenomenal. They have been engaged since the first minute that they got here.
And if they just ignore those cultural norms or whatever they should be doing or anything like that, they're going to be doing what they're supposed to be doing, which is designing machinery, doing biomechanical engineering, doing mechanical engineering.
I feel like you should just do whatever you want. Like, just do whatever your heart tells you to do.
I want to be a software developer somewhere in computer science engineering.
I'm really interested in possibly some engineering career, so I thought it was a really good camp for me. I'm definitely doing it next year.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Spicer.